morning, students. In last class, we have discussed the formation of an organic and micro molecules. Now, coming to the formation of macro molecules. What about the formation of macromolecules? So here the simple organic micromolecules which are present in, they are combined with one another. So here it helpful for the formation of a macro molecules. So here how they are molecules means condensation, by means the elimination of elimination of water molecule, the elimination of water molecule. Here we can able to produce the macro molecules. That example, if we take in the first year we have studied in biomolecules. So here condensation of water molecule. Elimination of one water molecule, we can able to produce the macro molecules. So here by the here it helpful for the macro molecules means, for example, take amino acid plus an amino acid. Here it can able to produce a protein molecule. So proteins are the macro molecules where they are present in the living organisms. So here it helpful for the formation of amino acid. One amino acid of ammonia group, another amino acid of carboxylic group, where here by elimination of one water molecule, here it can able to produce a protein molecule. Likewise, here carbohydrates, the monosaccharides plus monosaccharides combines together to form a polysaccharides. Here, monosaccharides. Here, it can able to produce a polysaccharides. So here, these polysaccharides which are formed, that are produced by the two monomers, that is monosaccharides and monosaccharides. So here, these polysaccharides, proteins, lipids, nucleic acids. So these are the macromolecules where it can able to formation. That means by the combination of two amino acids, or proteins, or the monosaccharides, or lipids, or nucleic acids. Here it helpful for the formation of the macro molecules. Here macromolecules means here micromolecules are converted into the macromolecules by the condensation of water or by the elimination of water. Here we can able to produce the macro molecules. Next, coming to the fifth one, that is formation of nucleic acids. Sugar with a nitrogen base. Here, sugar plus a nitrogen base. Nitrogen base, where we can call it as nucleosides. Nucleosides. Here, nucleosides means it is a combination of sugar molecule plus a nitrogen base. Here nitrogen bases are we can call them as the amino acids that are produced, here we are having the nitrogen bases. There are the four nitrogen bases are present in adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine. So in a DNA, here will consist of adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymidine. So these are the four nitrogen bases where they are present in the DNA. And here in RNA, here instead of RNA, here thymine is replaced by the uracil. So here in RNA, here adenine, guanine, cytosine, instead of thymine, here it consists of uracil is present in the DNA and RNA, where we can call that nucleosides. So here nitrogen bases, there are four nitrogen bases: adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymine, and uracil. They are present in where four, the thymine is present in the DNA and uracil is present in RNA. So here these combination that is figures with the nitrogen bases are combined together to form a nucleosides. Plus nucleosides plus phosphate or phosphoric acid. Here it combines with the nucleosides as phosphate, here it forms a nucleic acids. Nucleic acids. So here nucleic acids are presenting in a living organisms only. So here it helpful for the formation of a first formed an organism, that means first form of life. Here the nucleic acids which are presenting, it shows that the first form of a life is presenting, where the nucleic acids are presenting. So here it is called as the first form of a life is produced, that is from the formation of the nucleic acids. So here the nucleic acids are produced from sugar plus nitrogen bases and a phosphate together. We can call them as a nucleic acid. These nucleic acids are present only in a living organisms. They are present only in a living organism. So that here it shows that these are the first form of a life. And here it shows that here is helpful for the first form of life. It shows that the protobionts, the formation of the first form of life, it shows the formation of protobionts. Here are helpful for the formation of the protobionts are formation, that is the formation of nucleic acids, where the nucleic acids are present only in living organisms. These are absent in non-living organisms. So that here it shows that when nucleic acids formations are taken place, here it shows that the first form of life is presenting. So that first form of life which are presenting, we can call them as protobionts. Next, coming to the formation of a pre-cell. So here the formation, here it shows that two theory, that is most acceptable theory is the Sigmox theory. The most acceptable theory is the Sigmox Sidna Obsateri. Sidna Obsateri. So according to this theory, here it shows that here the amino acids which are present in the amino acids are heated. Amino acids. Amino acids which are present in these are heated. Where these are when these heated, they are produced in the form of proteinoids. Proteinoids. And these are heated. The amino acids are taken place, these are heated, when these are heated, here it can be able to producing the droplets. The droplets which are present in the form of proteins, the droplets which are found in the form of proteins, they are called as a proteinoids. Where these thermally produced proteinoids are aggregated in the form of spherically colloid droplets. It is spherically colloid droplets, we can call them as microspheres. Microspheres. That means these are thermally colloidal substances. That thermally colloidal substances which are present here, we can call them as the microspheres. These microspheres are resembles of a spherical shape. Spherical shape bacteria. These are like a spherical shape bacteria. These are examples where here we can see these are consist of a semi-permeable membrane is presenting, and also here it undergoes a reproduction by the fragmentation as well as a binary fission. That means these are spherically coiled, which are called thermally spherically colloidal substances which are formed. They are called as microspheres. These microspheres are examples of spherical shaped bacteria. These spherical shaped bacteria which are presented here will having measurement during the size along evolution. Here these will be bonded by the semi-permeable barrier like living organisms. Here it shows the passage of materials in and out of the vesicles. Here this will consist of in first spherical, that is a semi-permeable membrane. So that here this acts as semi-permeable membrane. It consists of a semi-permeable membrane. So here it helps for exchange of material in and outlets of the vesicles. Then they can place by the semi-permeable membrane, and also here these are reacted with these spheres, microspheres, they are reacted with the chemical substances, reacting with the chemical substances where they are taken place in a living organisms. And also here they undergoes a reproduction. They undergoes a reproduction. That reproduction will be by the fragmentation as well as a binary fission. Here it helps to for the formation of free cells. That means here it shows that the theory most acceptable is the Fox theory. According to this theory, it shows that the amino acids are collided and they are heated, it produces a colloidal structures called as proteinoids. These proteinoids are thermally colloidal, they are thermally heated, and also they are colloidal spherical substances which are present. We can call them as microspheres. These microspheres are resembles with the spherical shape bacteria, where it consists of these are having surrounded by the semi-permeable membrane, where here influx and outflux, that is in and outflow of the materials exchange are taking place of the vesicles. And also here it shows here reacting with the chemical substances in the living organism. That means in living organisms how chemical substances are binded with one another. Here in this also it shows the chemical reactions are taking place. And also here reproduction is taken place by fragmentation and binary fission, where here it shows the formation of a pre-SLS. Next, coming to the pre-cell to the SL. So here, what are the pre-cell development is taken place? Here it consists of nucleic acids are present in pre-cells, not only acquiring ability of replication, but also directed the series of chemical reactions during a protein synthesis. That means here the pre-cells which are present, here what are the proteins are presenting? Here will undergo self-replication. Here, that means when self-replication is taken place, the proteins which are presenting, these proteins will undergo self-replication. Self-replicated, where it has to look for the formation of a protein synthesis. It has to look for the formation of protein synthesis. This protein synthesis is taken place in an living organisms only. So here it is a significant step where it helpful for the formation of it is where the cell, the germinal cell, is converted into a cell where the amino acids are common to form proteins. These proteins are helpful for self replicating and produced in the form of a protein synthesis. So it is of the one of the major step where it helpful for the formation of a pre-cell to the SL. So due to this formation of pre-cell to the SL, here it helpful for the formation of the first form of a life is taken place. Due to this formation here, the first form of life. Here, it helpful for the formation of first form of a life is taken place. Where here the pre-cell is converted into cell by growing a self-replicated with the process of called a protein synthesis. So that is how the pre-cell is converted into a cell. And lastly, the initiation of where the first form of life engages through the chemical evolution. The chemical evolution, leads to the biological evolution. Leads to the the chemical evolution, that means from simple substances where the inorganic substances are converted into an organic, where it forms the first form of life, that is the chemical evolution. This chemical evolution will lead to the biological evolution, that is called as the initiation of biological and evolution. Next, coming to the last one. Initiation of a biological evolution. So here the initiation of a biological evolution, the cell which is formed, the first formed cell which is formed, it is an heterotrophic cell. That means what is the cell? That means from pre-cell to the cell which is formed, the first form of life which is formed, that first form of life is an heterotrophic cell. These heterotrophic cells is utilize the biological, that is utilize the prebiotic environment. Here it is helpful for the oxidation, that means utilization of all materials, that means mineral salts, and also here essential elements which are available for the SL that are all are utilized by the mineral salts or the prebiotic environment which is taken place in the oceans that are absorbed, that are taken place, that are utilized by the and heterotrophic cell. Where here it is helpful for the increasing of the CO2, the carbon dioxide level, increase of the carbon dioxide. So by these spontaneous mutations, by the undergoing spontaneous, random mutations, mutation means sudden change in a gene. Here the sudden change in the gene of heterotrophic gene is the heterotrophic cell is taken place, where here it helpful for the formation of due to this here it formation of chlorophyll pigments, chlorophyll. So due to the formation of chlorophyll, here what happens, here the heterotrophic cell is converted into an autotrophic cell. Is converted into an autotrophic cell. These autotrophic ones, it is by formation of chlorophyll pigments. Here the heterotrophic cell is converted into an autotrophic cell. Here with the help of photosynthesis, with the help of photosynthesis, here it is helpful for the preparing of the whole food materials by the chlorophyll pigments, so that here the autotrophic cell, where the carbon dioxide increases at the time, here oxygen is not being present, that is reduced condition, reduced, it is in the form of reduced agent, where when it is in a reduced agent, it is converted into an oxidizing agent. Here the carbon dioxide process is taken place by the plants by the process of photosynthesis. Here oxygen is released, but in a prebiotic environment the oxygen is not being present, and they are combined with other elements like water or oxides of silicons or oxides of iron. So this is helpful for combining. Once a reduced condition is converted into an oxidized agent, here the releasing of oxygen is releasing, where free oxygen is present, where here when free oxygen is taken place, here it helpful for the formation of an ozone layer. The ultraviolet radiation, so that here when ultraviolet radiation are taken place, it prevents the ozone layer formation is taken place due to the releasing of an oxygen during oxidizing an agent. So when it is taken place, here it is reducing environment is converted into an oxidizing, and environment reduces the ultraviolet radiations. This provides stability of progressive form of elements. And ozone formation is taking place, it's helpful for the formation of progressively development of a living organism of a life or other life. That means here progressively helpful for the formation of life, that is it helpful for the initiation of a biological and evolution. That is heterotrophic cell is converted into an autotrophic cell, where here reducing environment is converted into an oxidizing environment. That means firstly there is no oxygen, but later when it is converted into an autotrophic cell, here by the process of photosynthesis, here oxygen is released. So so that carefree oxygen is available, so an oxidizing environment is taken place where it's helpful for the formation of ozone, so that ultraviolet radiations are prevented from this. So progressively, the life is existed on the Earth surface. So this is how the evolution is taken place by simple, from a simple inorganic substances. Here, the organism, the life is produced on the Earth. So you can call as a theory of chemical evolution of life, or we can call as a molecular evolution, where it takes place as several steps to form a life on the Earth surface. That means a cell can evolve to, that means living organism can evolve to survival on the Earth surface. So this is the topic of a theory of chemical evolution. So in next class we'll discuss that is Stanley Miller an experiment, how the how the life is produced from simple inorganic substances, that is proved by the Stanley and Miller with experiment. We can able to do, we'll discuss, so that is we'll discuss in the next class.